sport now. The ANZ Netball Cup is over for the second year. Five Australian teams and five New Zealand teams battled it out in what was ultimately a disappointing season for the Kiwi teams. But did the competition benefit our Pacific players? Nikki Sualepa went courtside to find out.
An All-Australian final in Melbourne last weekend saw the Melbourne Vixens beat the Adelaide Thunderbirds 54-46. The only Kiwi team to get a sniff of the finals was the Waikato Magic, who bowed out in the semis. Despite the results this year, the ANZ Netball Cup is the closest the code has come to professionalism. So, has it made a difference for our girls?
This season has been, it's been great. Each week it's kind of like playing, it's the New Zealand-Australian rivalry. So, I mean, again, for the young ones who are wanting to succeed in netball and wanting to play in the ANZ Champs, it's a great taster for them of what international netball is like.
I'm really enjoying it, being back in, you know, I can't believe it when I had a year off and, I've missed netball so much, so that's why I'm back. And now it's just great to be back, to be part of an amazing group of women.
Samoan shooter Paula Griffin's move from the Northern Mystics to last place holders Central Pulse saw the team's first ever win in the competition.
What I was in for when I went down there, and I knew it was going to be a challenge, but it was all about opportunity, and you know that one win was the best one of my career.
Although the code still can't match the pay packets of the fellas just yet, the ANZ Cup's semi-pro status gives players a base salary of $15,000 a year. New Zealand and Australian reps can negotiate up to $100,000 with a few extras on the side.
There's a lot of perks that you get, being a professional netball player. Cars, contracts, money, free travel.
Financially, like, the money's a lot better. And the competitiveness with the Trans-Tasman is, heaps better than what it was a couple of years back.
Financially, it pays a few bills, but we still have to sort of find something else to help cover everything else, all our debts and stuff.
Despite an uninspiring result from the Kiwi teams this year, the Pacific Island players continue to bring an X factor to the game.
I think the natural flair, natural ability, just that sort of wow factor in games, and just that natural skill, I reckon, and just heaps of laughs. Heaps of laughter.
Yeah, definitely, heaps of laughs.
You always see in training, it's always the PI girls
always
that are cracking up, joking, everyone else is serious, running the beep test, we're having a good laugh.
There's an easygoing feeling within the team, but there is a competitiveness to make sure that they put what game they want to showcase their skills out on court.
The passion and the flair, it's more the flair than, and the enjoyment, the fun of it. Yeah, and we're strong too, yeah.
They just bring this whole different flair of style. We're really aggressive and really into it and bring a lot of laughter and funniness into the team.
While Pacific players seem to have made their mark in the ANZ Cup, will there be a future for the Cup itself?
I think it's going to get bigger. I think we're going to see more competitiveness. I think it's really exciting, the future of netball.
Exciting prospects indeed. Good luck to Paula Griffin and Grace Rasmussen and all of the Pacific teams competing next month at the 2009 World Youth Netball Championships in Rarotonga.